Let's see the life cycle of an angiospermic plant. Here they have given a clear flowchart for the life cycle of an angiospermic plant. Let's start with the seeds. Germination of the seeds. Once the seed got germinated, that stage we call it as seedling stage. After seedling stage, it will develop into a young plant. So the young plant will mature into a very big plant, which we call it as mature angiosperm plant, which is diploid in nature. And this diploid plant will give rise to reproductive structures which other than flowers. Flowers are also diploid. So in these flowers we have two important structures, that is pistil and stamen. Pistil we call it as megasporangiate organ, and stamen we call it as microsporangiate organ. Megasporangiate organ means which is female. Microsporangiate organ is male. So the stamens are male and pistils are female. Both are also diploid in nature because these are the very needed or very important structures for the flowers for fertilization purpose. And in the megasporangiate organ, we have the ovary. Inside the ovary, we'll have the ovules. So here in the microsporangiate organ, we'll have the microsporangium, which is a 2N. Ovary is also diploid and microsporangium is also diploid. And again the ovary, inside the ovary will have the ovules, which is in turn again diploid. Here the sporogenous tissue. So inside the anther will have the sporogenous tissue, which is again diploid. So with this, from here the megasporangium and here the microsporangium. So from here we will have the tissue called nucellus. From the nucellus only, the megaspore mother cell will regenerate. So the megaspore mother cell undergo the meiosis division and will give rise to megaspore. So the megaspore is haploid. So the haploid megaspore consists of embryonic sac with 7-celled stage. So let's 7-celled but 8 nucleus stage. 7-celled and 8 nucleus. So inside the embryonic sac will have the egg cell and secondary nucleus. The secondary nucleus is diploid in nature with 2 nucleus, because having the 2 haploid nucleus, so together we call it as diploid. But the egg cell is having haploid nucleus. So this is been completed by the megaspore. When coming to the microspore mother cell, this also will undergo the meiosis and will create microspore, which other than pollens. Here we have the pollens and here we have embryonic sac. The pollens have 2-celled, so microspore at the time of pollination, which gives rise to generative cell. So this generative cell will undergo male gamete. 2 male gametes will divide into 2 male gametes. So the egg cell will fuse with 1 male gamete and the secondary nucleus will fuse with other male gamete. Finally, this 2 fertilization, so that fertilization will happen 2 times. So we call it as double fertilization processes, syngamy. So the fusion of egg cell and male gamete, we call it as syngamy. The fusion of secondary nucleus and male gamete, we call it as primary endosperm nucleus. This primary endosperm nucleus will give rise to triploid endosperm, and the zygote will give rise to embryo. So the embryo will give rise to multicellular embryo, and the endosperm gives rise to nutrition provided by free nuclear or cellular endosperm. So for example, coconut water is a nuclear endosperm. So free nuclear endosperm, which gives nutrition to the seed. So multicellular embryo. And finally, these two together will form a seed. And these seed will mature inside the fruit. And the dispersal of the seed will happen due to many mediums. And finally, the seed will germinate. Again, the circle will continue like this. So this is the whole life cycle of angiospermic plant. So angiospermic plant is diplontic type due to predominance of diploid phases, because you can see the majority of the stages are diploid. Only the minor phase we have the haploid. The majority will be diploid. So diplontic type of life cycle. So this is the life cycle of angiospermic plant. Okay, my dear friends, thank you very much.